Thank you. I know this is the oldest Presbyterian joke in the world, but I'm going to tell it to you today to introduce the Pentecost theme. It's about the old and established Presbyterian Church where they're having their normal worship, and a stranger comes in, and the stranger is obviously from some different religious tradition, because during the singing of the hymns, they stand up and they wave their arms and they start shouting, "Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Amen!" And there's two old, dignified Presbyterians sitting in the back, and the one says to the other, "What's wrong with that guy?" And the other one says, "Well, I think he's got the Holy Spirit." And the first one says, "Well, I don't know what he's got, but I know he didn't catch it here." See, that's a very mean joke to Presbyterians, really, because it's saying that we don't have the Holy Spirit. And that's not right. You all have the Holy Spirit, and we celebrate it, but sometimes we make the mistake that the Holy Spirit has to do with strange, ecstatic gifts of dancing, or speaking in tongues, or ecstatic visions, and there's other stuff, more important and more substantial stuff than that about the Holy Spirit that you all have within you. And this goes back to the story of Pentecost that is told by Luke. And remember, the person who wrote the Gospel of Luke also wrote the Acts of the Apostles. And he tells this story of the flames coming down from heaven and of the people then being able to speak in tongues. And we make the mistake of reading that story in a really shallow and superficial way without thinking about it and without thinking about the deep power and significance in behind that shallow, superficial story. But I'm going to tell you about the deeper meaning today, and you will all go out of here knowing that you have got the Holy Spirit in you, and you are going to change the world